Oh, say, can you see?
It's the song that means so much.
By the dawn's early light.
To so many of us, in so many different ways. And there's a lot that many of us may not even know about our national anthem. Like, for more than 150 years, we didn't have one.
In fact, we didn't even have a national anthem. There was no official national anthem until 1931. This despite the fact that Francis Scott Key wrote the words that will become the Star Spangled Banner during the War of 1812.
Mark Leibson wrote the book on it, What So Proudly We Hailed. The story of Francis Scott Key, attorney and patriot, detained on a British ship during the War of 1812, inspired as he saw the stars and stripes flying overhead. What might he have thought of the role his words would play in a time of national unrest over 200 years later? The Dallas Mavericks briefly stopped playing it before games last month until the NBA stepped in.
I guess it could be viewed as not patriotic.
Fans are still a little torn about that.
I don't think it should be forced on anyone.
Like, I guess I could kneel or something, right? Like, I don't have to, like, go with it.
You pointed to Kaepernick.
Yeah, I was thinking because that's what he did. And that's the argument. So I don't know, maybe you should just, like, be free to do what you believe.
Yes, it's an ad, but it's also a massive reminder of the anthem's current role in our national conversation about race and equality. Right outside the home of the New York Knicks.
Play it. Why not? I mean, we've got to be proud of our country, right?
The first time the national anthem was ever played at a sporting event was the 1918 World Series. It didn't start to be regularly played at games until World War II, 1942 to be exact. And guess which groups played maybe the biggest role in making it America's song?
The big veteran service organizations, the American Legion and the VFW, started a nationwide campaign in the early 1900s, and in January of 1930, the VFW presented a petition with 5 million signatures to Congress asking that the song become the national anthem.
It was the Navy that used the song first, 40 years before the rest of us. Just a bit of history, whether you stand or kneel or sing.
For the land.
Here, so I can say what I want.
In New York, Tom Negovan, News Nation.